Hello, friend! Welcome back to my channel. Thanks for coming back. I have another fantastic resource for you from Evan Moor. I know my last video that I posted was an Evan Moor resource, but you just gotta know that as the year ebbs and flows, I'm always going back to Evan Moor because they always have fantastic supplemental resources that are super affordable. Like, have I said this enough times? Never. I will always shout it because sometimes in our school, we just get tired of the book that I've picked or the curriculum or whatever it is. But the concept, of course, is something that we're still learning. And usually without fail, I can find an Evan Moor book and be able to pull out a piece of it. And I never feel bad for not doing the entire book, like from beginning to end, because it's so affordable. And do they have like full curriculums that you can do for your child for like all of their schooling? Yeah, they do. They have like bundles. You can just save money, obviously, by buying the bundle. But so many of their resources are affordable and you can, you know, pick and choose what you want, and it's so great. So anyway, with that being said, today I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about another writing resource that Evan Moor has. This one's called Real World Writing. The end. Real world writing. And they have it for grades 1 through 6. Now, the way that this book, there are 3 books. They have the grades chunked together. So you can buy grades 1 and 2, 3 and 4, or 5 and 6. So that's fantastic, especially if you have kids that are really close in skill level, then you can use the same resource for those 2 or 3 or whatever number of kids. This resource is also an ebook only. At the time of this filming, you can't buy it as a physical copy. And dear Evan Moor, if you could please make this book a physical copy, it would be fantastic. Love, Kaylin. Because I do love this resource, but I'm gonna be honest, it is hard to use a material that is an ebook. So I do print off the pieces that I want, but I haven't yet print out the entire book because it's like 134 pages and all of it is like fantastic content. But if you've been around for a while, you know that sometimes I'm like, I just can't be bothered with printing the stuff out. I just need to have it. So keep that in mind if you want to go and look at that resource. I know that it's kind of like a rough thing to start with, but it is an ebook, and so you do have to print out the pages that you want. Now, that being said, there is an option. So remember when last year when I was traveling all that time, having online documents was like the best thing for me because I didn't have this classroom. I didn't have anything, right? And we were constantly on the road. We were schooling out of a Tupperware. And so anything that I could get online was perfect for me. So ebooks are fantastic in their space as well because you don't have to have all of the papers. You don't have to have all of the printing and everything. You can just pull it up on your screen and kind of like, I have my computer right here. So let me just show you what I'm saying. Oh gosh, I got to scroll way down. You can just show your student like, okay, here we are. Or if you can like project it up onto a TV or a bigger screen or whatever, and like even have it on your phone and then just like airplay it or something, then you can talk about it together and everyone can just have a little notebook that then they can do the activity with instead of having like the printed out copy. So there is that option as well. My brain doesn't go there immediately because of the way that my classroom is set up, but that doesn't mean your classroom is set up like mine. And maybe this is a resource or an ebook is like right up your alley and it's totally what you want to do. So without further ado, let's talk about a little bit about what's in this book. So before I take too much of your time, let me just let you know, in the description box below is the link for this resource, and you can go over there and then you can like look at all the stuff and kind of feel it out for yourself. Again, because it's an online resource or an ebook, I don't have like all of the pages that I can show you. I did print off a few things and I'll just tell you like what I think about it, which which is worth its weight in gold, right? Like Kaylin's opinion. Okay, so like I mentioned, this is a real world writing, and I'm actually gonna be looking at the book here since I can't like hold it up and like show you, okay? So what you're gonna get, it is intended to be a weekly activity, and how you choose to set it up is your call, of course. Like we always take longer than we probably should because I just like to do that. I can never leave well enough alone. I always have to like rewrite it and interject a bunch of garbage. But you're gonna get 24 weekly units. So there's 24 weeks worth of content, and you're gonna be writing, it's real world. So you're gonna be teaching your student how to function in a world where we need to express ourselves in writing. This is a hugely beneficial skill that sometimes I think is missed because we're so busy teaching phonics or reading comprehension or what did the author mean when they said this, like all of that kind of language arts skill that we sometimes breeze past. Well, how do you write a letter? Like, how do you write an email? How do you do an internet search and then write about like how you found all of that information, right? So that's what you're gonna learn with this real world writing. And again, it's all leveled. So I have, the one that I'm gonna be discussing specifically will be levels 1 and 2 because I have a first grader. So mine is gonna be geared toward her. But if you have a 6th grader, I also have a 4th grader, you can do this as well with them, okay? So you're gonna teach how to write an email. You're gonna teach how to write a journal entry, which is a lost art. Can we go back to writing journal entries? Like recording our personal history is vitally important, especially in the day and age that we live in right now, where information is misconstrued all the time. Like we need to be teaching our families and ourselves how to write a journal entry so that our posterity can look back and know what was it like to live in 2021, 2022, right? Like these are really vital years in the history of the United States, and the history can be misconstrued if it's not recorded. So journal entries, thank you notes, again, internet search, a biography, like again, this is a lost art. And are you teaching your kids to interview grandparents or aunts and uncles or the generation before them or 2 generations before them so that they can learn those histories? Because again, in a world of today, and I know that you know, so much of our history has been lost because it's just not being taught, right? There was a day when men would go and enlist in the war and they would go off across overseas and they were fighting the Great War and coming home with these stories of patriotism and what it was like. And they stood for our country in patriotism and they knew the Constitution and they knew what they were standing for. And to interview and talk to those people and know how to write their biographies is just really a valuable skill. So obviously I'm a little more passionate about this than I thought I was gonna be. Infographics, this is such a skill of today. And I know like I'm teaching a 1st grader, so she's got a long way to go before this is gonna be something that she implements or that she remembers to know how to implement. But infographics is a huge way that information is conveyed in 2021. So, okay, so that's where it kind of starts. And the way that they break it down here is that in every lesson, you're going to get a teacher overview. So background content for you so that you kind of know, well, how do I set up this lesson? Then you're going to get a scenario and a model and like a sample writing assignment that then you can work with or assign to your child. They do a graphic organizer as the next step. So I guess this could be like day 1, 2, and now day 3. You do like a graphic organizer so that the student can organize their thoughts before they do the final activity, which is your writing task. So let me just kind of show you one specific one. Now I didn't print off the teacher portion of it. So, but anyway, the first part, this is going to be like the first lesson, which is going to be writing a letter. And my daughter is like really keen on writing letters right now. She loves sending notes to cousins. She runs to the neighbor's house like 3 times a week with a letter. So this really like spoke to me because I knew that it would really interest her. So, the first one is how to write a friendly letter. And this is like the sample engagement thing that you're going to show your student. Okay. First of all, can we just talk about the no color thing? I know you're thinking it because you've been here for a minute and you know Kaylin's thing about Evan Moor is like, it's so colorful. No, this is an ebook. So your printer will be happy, but your heart will be sad. Okay. My heart's not that sad. I don't know why I said that. Okay. So here's your sample letter and it's just it's going to just show just the basic, like, how do you set up a letter, right? So the date's on one side, dear grandma, indent, you have little paragraphs, the love is kind of in the center here. So it just kind of gives them a visual of like, oh, I've never seen a letter written like this before. And even like in emails don't look like this. So for your older students, it's a lost art, right? Letter writing is a lost art, but hopefully us homeschoolers can instill the beauty of letter writing, right, in our kids so that it's not forever gone. Okay. So now here's page 2. You're going to duplicate what you saw, but they've like set it up here for you so that you can write a letter to grandma. And the whole point of this is, you're going to write, grandma's moved away. His grandma used to live next door. Now she lives in another city. Write a letter to grandma. So I guess you don't have to write a letter to grandma. You can write a letter to whoever you want. But here you go. It's date, greeting, news and questions, closing, and your name. Okay? So then this is like a sample thing. Oh, that's your graphic organizer. Kaylin, could you freaking pay attention? This is your graphic organizer. So even if you had your kid just like write bullets or draw a picture or something to kind of like put their thoughts on there. All right. Here is, pretend that it's summer, you'll have a new teacher in the fall. His name is Mr. Otto. He wrote you a letter to welcome you. Write back. Tell him about yourself. So now it's going to be like the actual writing activity. You're going to write a letter back to your new teacher. And now this is going to be another option where you're going to pretend that your friend moved away, write a friendly letter. So you have 4 pages of activities if you have a 4-day school week or do one every week. And then you're going to have in this resource 24 of those types of lessons. Okay. So, there is a table of contents. Again, if you go to the description box below, there'll be a link, but I'll just verbally kind of go over it with you really quick. I know I can't show, I mean, I could like hold up my computer, but so the first one is going to be letter writing. You're going to learn how to express yourself. So we have the friendly letter, which is the one that I showed you. Thank you notes, greeting cards, and journal entries are the 4 weeks worth of content that you're going to get for letter writing. Okay. The next one is going to, the subject line is to help others know. So you're going to teach, how to write an invitation, how to write a set of rules, how to write directions, and then how to write a description. The third chunk is going to be, critique carefully. So you're going to critique books and shows, critique foods, like a food opinion, critique products, and critique the weather. Then, section 4, which would be like the 4th month, you're going to, do questioning. So it's called dive in deep. So you're going to do a family interview, an internet search, a new friend letter. So a letter to someone who is a new friend, and science questions. Look more closely is the 5th month of lessons. So you're going to do a choice list, comparison, observations, and diagrams. And then the last month, the 6th section is going to be persuade to solve. You're going to write an advertisement. You're going to write a letter requesting something. You're going to write a presentation, and then you're going to write some feedback. Your student will. So anyway, it's just an awesome way to teach your kid how to write in real life instead of write a story about a cat in a tree or whatever. Like, those writing styles are also interesting, or writing comic strips or writing books or whatever your kids are really interested in. But these types of skills are also super, super important. And to introduce it to your kids when they're young will give them the foundation so that as they grow, then they'll be able to to use those skills and remember them and be able to build upon them. So, like I mentioned, this is just grade one, and I haven't seen the older grades, but my fourth grader, who is using a different curriculum, we just barely went through, I believe it's like unit five probably, anyway, about writing and like how to write a letter, how to address an envelope. Like it's all of this kind of stuff, but I just appreciate so much how Evan Moor approaches it, because it just is visually more digestible for me. And so if you're a visual learner like I am, then this is, Evan Moor is just a really great resource, because they just present it in such a visually appealing way that it's easy for us visual learners to be able to ingest the information and understand it. And then those who are audio learners or audible learners, is that the right word? Anyway, then you can talk to them or teach them in the description and showing them all that stuff. So anyway, it's just a fantastic resource. I cannot recommend it enough. I promise you my next video is going to be an update, because it's been several weeks since I've updated you on our homeschool life. So I'll make sure and get that video filmed and out to you guys too. So anyway, thanks again for taking some time. Hopefully this resource is of value to you. If you have questions or comments, leave them in the section below. I always look those up for you as well. And make sure you have a great day. Talk to you later, guys.